Welcome to the show. Can you believe it is Thursday already? I can believe it was Thursday. I lost track of time. I thought it was Wednesday. On today's stream, I'm hoping that we're going to actually get this page finished. Terms of progress that I've made so far, I would say absolutely none whatsoever since yesterday. So that's all right. There's not a whole lot more to do on this page besides the last panel, so maybe I can get this done today, or at least very close. I'm gonna fill this area in because I don't know, it just looks weird to me, have that gap there. And then we're going to move on. Same as with the previous panels, what I'm going to do is lower the opacity of the mock-up art, and then I'm going to begin drawing Sadie's actual art over the kind of crude wireframe version that I put in there when I was doing the layouts. I might need to probably position the eyes back a little bit so that she doesn't end up looking cross-eyed. I don't care for the shape of that mouth. I'm gonna have to tweak that a little bit, I think. I'm really having some trouble today. Getting the eyes to be exactly what I want them to be. Pull this chin a little bit, I think, as well. Again, a bit more than I did initially.
Yeah.
And you may have noticed I've been kind of quiet on today's show. Mostly just because I'm really concentrating. And working very hard to get everything right here. But also, you may have also noticed I'm working in a very different sort of style here to my usual sort of process. I've been very sketchy today. And that really hasn't been a conscious decision. I think I'm just trying to work everything out on the fly. And I'm not worrying too much about, you know, if my lines are very sketchy, very scratchy, then I'll come back and just gradually refine anything. I don't know if what you're actually witnessing is. So I'm shifting my process. I don't usually lay down tons and tons of lines, for example, to get something like the shape of Sadie's blazer correct, which is kind of the way that I've done it here. You might have seen earlier, I just sort of did like a brute force attack where I just laid down a whole bunch of pen strokes and then used the eraser to carve out the exact shape that I wanted. And I did the same thing with Sadie's hair earlier. It was when I was doing the top of her head, it was to get the shape exactly what I wanted. Just doing a bunch of lines and then using the eraser to remove the lines that were incorrect and leave whatever was closest to what I wanted. Okay, how much have I been dragging my feet about doing the hand here? Kind of advice, maybe the part of the body five times over. And I haven't even started on this hand yet, although it's kind of going to have to go halfway out of the panel. Yeah, I actually don't like it. In terms of, I feel like it'd be better if it was just a follow on. A form balled up fist. But they won't leave any room between the fingers and the thumb. Again, it's still very maybe it's off panel, anywhere half of it's off panel, but on the other hand, it's going to be obscured by Jesse's shoulder anyway, so which was not a deliberate design decision, by the way, said to to get me out of having to draw two hands. I know that's an old trick for artists, finding ways to strategically, you know, place elements in such a way or draw characters in such a way that they can get out of drawing hands and feet. Not something that I am guilty of usually. Although, with that said, there have been times when I would get halfway through drawing something and realise that for whatever reason I didn't need to draw it on your hands or feet, usually hands, and then it's really a sigh of relief. But I don't usually go looking for a way out. few more tweaks to make here and there, I think. And then we'll be done with Sadie.
Thank you.
going to pull part of the arm out here a little bit because I feel like the two arms are not quite balanced in terms of width. So. A long way in the day to make a change like that. Hopefully that's not going to mess things up too much. Okay. Next step is I'm going to pull up Josie's model sheet here. Move that to my other monitor. So we're going to start laying down Josie's line out as well. No, I don't care for any of this. I think I might just wipe this out and start again. I don't know, sometimes you're not on the right path, you know, and you can't dig yourself out of it by just continuing to draw and add more stuff to the existing image. Need to take what you've done and start over. So I'm going to try and use the fill an image from the storyboard as a base here. Because there's nothing really wrong with it. For our purposes, we're going to end up covering up a lot of it because we're looking at just even the back of, or almost from, you know, the back of the head. So invariably we're going to end up covering a lot of it up, but it's very difficult. I don't have full sort of a turnaround sheet for Josie. I really don't have any for any of the characters except for Corinne, because really because of it was time constraints at the time that I was making the model sheets. And given the size of the cast and the fact that I'm only one person, I just did not have the resources to be able to create turnaround sheets for every single character. So that's a lot better than the first attempt, and I think a lot of that comes down to the fact that I really simplified the what I'm doing here versus the first go that I had at it there trying to add in the ear. We wouldn't even really see the ear because obviously the hair's coming down off the back of the head and it's obscuring our view of it anyway, so we don't really need to the full view of the ear. The ear would really be behind this strand of hair here. From our perspective anyway. And then as you turned around, you would see more of it. Maybe just for a hint of the bottom of the ear as well. Yeah, we're not going to get this page finished today on stream because there's still a little bit more work to do. By the time we're done here, we've got about 15 minutes left on today's show, but by the time we're done with Josie's line art here, still going to have to lay down a lot of spot black areas across all the panels, and we also still have the lettering to do as well. So yeah, we're nearing the end on page 17, but we're not quite there yet. We'll go back to Sadie's lair. Just move. And get the extra line up. Oh, that didn't take long. Kind of got curled up in my seat there. It feels good to stretch if you've been sitting in a drone for almost 2 hours. Okay, I'm just thinking about speech bubble placement. I'm nice to worry about there. Bit of detailing on the hair like we did yesterday, and I think this is going to be our last task for today. And really just said, what are the lights, Stokes? Heard the car as I'm close at the light source and then pulling back, bunching Stokes a lot more closely together as we pull back further towards the back of Josie's head and, you know, where the shadow would be. And what's going to happen is in each of these panels I've kind of done the same thing. It's a lot of very elaborate stroke detail to the end of Josie's hair, and a lot of that's actually going to get covered up because when I go back and add the spot black elements, some of this we're just going to layer over with pure black at the absolute darkest parts, but that's okay. Well, when I do that, I'll do that in a separate layer as well, just to make sure in case I go too far, and then I can sort of manage it the same way that we do with really every significant element on the page. You know, if there's an element that, you know, every time I draw Sadie, she'll get a new layer to herself. Every time I draw Josie, she'll get a new layer to herself. Every time I draw a new background, I'll add that as a separate layer as well, and then eventually when all layers, you know, get too numerous and they get hard to manage, once the art is all done on the menu, I'll start to consolidate them, merge them all back down again. But I think that is going to do it for today. We're just a little bit short of 4 p.m. But I don't think there's much more to do here beyond, like I said, the next stage is going to be to add those spot blacks and some of the background areas and some of the character art as well. And then it's going to be a case of do the lettering as well. So we might do that on tomorrow's stream. We might either do what's left on this page or, you know, get started on page 18. So tune in tomorrow and find out what happens. But for now, I want to thank you all for watching Club Kirby. Don't forget, we do this. I can't speak. I've hardly spoken on stream at all, and I can't speak. I want to thank you for joining me today on Club Kirby. We do this every afternoon UK time from 1400 hours to 1600 hours, or 2 p.m. till 4 p.m. if you're using the old fashioned clock method. We do this on Twitch, we do this on Periscope, we do this on Twitter, we do this on YouTube. So you can tune in wherever you want. Every weekday, pretty much every weekday, usually for 2 hours. And we're chipping away at this series of daily Kirby adventures. I hope we're going to be daily Kirby adventures. I still need to pick up the pace a bit though. But anyway, I hope to see you tomorrow for the Friday edition of Club Kirby.